Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 1865, eBay Gallery Multiple Image File Name Concatenate. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jellin. Today, this is a question that is probably faced by all eBay power sellers. There's a utility to upload your information to eBay, and you have to create these two text things, the main image, which has, you know, like for example, SKU and then 1.jpg, and then the media gallery. This is the one that's really, really hard because there are four images and it's Dale 1, Dale 2, Dale 3, Dale 4 with semicolons in between. And there can be anywhere from 1 to 30 images. So the question is, how do we build that string without simply just typing the whole thing? You know, and this is one, you know, I talked to Mike Girvin. I said, Mike, would this be a good dueling Excel podcast? You know, because what we need to do here, I've built a little formula that says, you know, take the base name and then concatenate it with row 1 to 30. And then, well, I guess actually it's .jpg. And that returns just the first item. But if I do F2, F9, I actually get almost what I need. There's the extra quotes around there, but you know, boy, if I could somehow just return this string to a cell, like if there was a way to use the text function or something like that, and if you're watching this, you might know a way to do that, but I couldn't figure it out. So that means I'm switching over to what I always do. I switch over to VBA. Now, a couple of things. If you have an Excel file and it's saved with this XLSX file extension, that is the worst Excel file extension there is. It's the only file extension in the history of the world that doesn't allow macros. And unfortunately, Microsoft makes this be the default, so it's very likely that you have this file type. If you do, you're going to have to do File, Save As, and save it. Not as the thwarted XLSX, but any of the real file types, XLSM or XLSB, any of those will work. It's just that crazy XLSX that does not allow macros, so save it that way. Also, if you've never done macros before, do Alt T followed by M followed by S, and make sure that you're not set on that top one. You want to go at least to the second security setting there. All right, so once we've done that, Alt F11, we're going to insert a module. I'm just going to paste it in. Okay, so here's some text that I wrote. We have a function called gallery. We're going to pass two things. The base text, that's the file name, the prefix file name, and then how many times we want to repeat. Now, we have to have a variable that matches that name that returns the answer at the end, so we initialize that to quote, quote, for I equals 1 to repeat count. So however many pictures we have, gallery is equal to the old version of gallery plus the base text, then the counter, and then the prefix.jpg with the semicolon. Do next I, so if there's four of them, it'll do bill 1, bill 2, bill 3, bill 4 with semicolons in between each one. And then finally, to get rid of that last semicolon, take the left of the gallery, the entire length of the gallery, minus 1, and that will be returned. So let's take a look at how that works. So we just come here and say equal gallery. Here's the base SKU and how many times we want to repeat. And it works perfectly. If we would say, for example, maybe 30, then it will repeat and we get our answer all the time. How do we get the main image? Well, that's easy. Just take the A3 ampersand, the number 1.jpg, all in quotes, and so that one is the easiest part. It's the media gallery that was tough. And I'm really interested in the YouTube comments. If you can come up with some sort of a formula that would do this so we wouldn't have to use VBA, I would love to see that. I never used the morefunk add-in, and I know they have an mconcat. I would guess that mconcat would let us do this, although I don't know if it handles an array, and I've heard there's problems to have morefunk work in the later versions of Excel. So I'm not sure that is a good option, but at least with this VBA, we can solve it for now. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast, Mr. Excel.